Your questions, sir. What's important about this story?
There are a couple of things. To the extent there are criminal allegations, Congress doesn't have a role in that. That's up to the executive branch, the FBI, and the Department of Justice. There may or may not be a congressional injury here. So the House Intel Committee on right now, sir, Chairman Nunes, has been looking into Russia for months and months and months. So the Democrats may be new to this investigation, but the Republicans in the House, as it relates to Russia and their attempts to interfere in our elections, we're not new to it.
Mitch McConnell said this morning, we know they were messing around, meaning the Russians. We don't know if it had an impact on our election. Where are you on that statement, sir?
The more information, the better. The more evidence, the better. But think back to yesterday, Bill. One of my Democrat colleagues said he wants public hearings. Public hearings on classified information. Whenever someone says they want public hearings about a classified matter, you just know they're not serious. So Congress is capable of investigating. In fact, we did it in the committee I was on. 99 out of our 100 interviews were done in private. The Democrats want this to be a public story. They're much more interested in the politics of it than they are actually finding out what happened.
But I think this is a critical component to the story about what Mitch McConnell addressed there. Don't know if the Russians had any impact in the outcome of the election. Do you concur with that, or do you have other information now, sir, that would suggest otherwise?
Well, it depends on how you frame the question. Was there an attempt to inject themselves in our election? That's the first question. Number two, was it successful? Number three, did it have any impact on the outcome? So those are separate lines of inquiry, each of which are appropriate, but you can't blur the lines and just say one. You got to look at all three of them, and those are three distinct lines of inquiry from my vantage point.
Got it, but how do you answer the critical one about the election involvement right now based on what you may or may not know? This is very important to nail this down. What do you understand?
You're talking about whether or not it actually had an impact or whether or not there was an effort to...
The former.
Whether or not it had an impact, I don't think anyone knows that. I've seen no evidence of it, and what I have seen in a skiff, which are classified materials, do not support the allegation that they successfully impacted the outcome of the election.
So that would match with what the New York Times is reporting that we talked about in our last segment here. More questions now. Who's behind these leaks?
No idea, Bill. I don't like unauthorized disclosures. I mean, the word leak is such a benign term. It's an unauthorized disclosure, which may be illegal. I don't have any idea who it is. I can tell you there is an insatiable appetite for leaks in this town, both on the receiving end and on the giving end. You didn't hear me talking about WikiLeaks because that was an unauthorized hack. I'm old school. I don't think you ought to disclose things that are intended to be kept confidential or classified.
Would Ben Rhodes be a person you would consider who worked in the Obama White House for 8 years?
It would not be fair to Mr. Rhodes or anyone else for me to throw out a name. I have no idea who did it. I think it's a separate inquiry from the substance of the leak. But when you have a classified transcript that makes its way into the public domain, I know the care that the intelligence community, for the most part, takes to protect classified information. The fact that you would leak it to the media is, in some instances, a crime. It's not just a leak, it's a crime.
Well, the reason I mentioned Mr. Rhodes is because others have put his name on the table in the past 24 hours. And you specifically, based on your Benghazi committee investigation, had direct contact with him. So again, are there individuals who are either holdovers from the previous administration or who have left as a result of the new administration who would have contacts with the intelligence community and would have direct contact with leading members of the DNC, sir?
There are thousands of people who would have access to this information, but it's not fair to them for me to guess whether it's Ben Rhodes. I heard a DOJ employee's name mentioned. It's not fair for me to name someone's name when I have no evidentiary support
fair
for
enough.
Even naming their name.
Let's leave that there for the moment. Will there be a select committee or not? Mitch McConnell seems to suggest that the Senate Intelligence Committee can handle this on their own. Where are you on that now?
We have a select committee. It's called the House Intelligence Committee. It is selected by the Speaker himself. It is a highly coveted committee. And he and the minority leader handpicked the people to be on that committee. So it's already select.
Sir, thank you for your time. I can tell the PA system is working there on Capitol Hill. Thanks for fighting through that.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
And your patience. You bet. Trey Gowdy on the